at work.
And we were told by our City Hall reporter, Bill Cameron, that this alderman, Shirley Coleman, in Greece, the D is silent. Little reference there for all you. That's a Birdcage for all you Birdcage fans out there. Shirley Coleman is going to launch an investigation into the treatment of minorities by broadcast entities. You know, and I think that the first person that should be called to that special subcommittee hearing at the city council is Oprah Winfrey.
Right.
To discuss her $1 billion.
And then Alicia Middlebrooks, who's right. The highest paid newsreader on radio in the country.
Then they should bring forth Diane Burns to explain her side of the story. Well, they were offering me $2.5 million, and I thought I could be making $3 or $4 million, and I was really going to try to hold them to the fire till Channel 2 hired me anyway, so that's what I was going to do.
And will Mayor Daley chime in on this? He usually knows what's going on over there, right?
Yeah, he'll zip it on this. He doesn't want to get into this. And Diane is possibly the highest paid local anchor in the country.
She might be. And she's going to make huge money on this. And she's going to go to Channel 2, and she's going to make money. And, you know, the truth will be told at that point whether she helps the ratings over there. She may very well. There's enough heat on this story now that maybe she does pop them a number over there. But the city council's going to hear it, going to have a hearing on that?
Well, she alluded to it. Bill's with us. Bill, is this formal that Alderwoman Coleman's going to ask for this? Or
They're thinking about calling for it. And you mentioned Mayor Daley. He actually toned them down a bit because they wanted for a boycott of Channel 7, and the mayor waved him off. No, let's not do that. Mayor later said that Diane is a wonderful anchor.
And we don't know how quite this bubbled to the surface and what route this took, because they usually pre-plan the meetings, right?
Wait a second. Hold on one second. We're going to call for a boycott because they couldn't come to terms?
That's what they wanted to do.
All right. Now, wait a second. Now, there was one other broadcast boycott in this town that I recall, and that's Channel 2 was boycotted because they, at that, there was a, the, Bill Curtis had gone off to New York, and they did not renew the contract of Harry Porterfield.
Right.
And Harry Porterfield ended up at Channel 7, where he still is today, some 20 years later. And the deal is that Jesse Jackson was involved in this too, right?
Yes.
There was a boycott, and then there was a march, and there was a this, and there was a that. And what ended up happening is Channel 2 ended up going out and hiring a number of minorities. None of them work for them anymore. Minorities that were already there, are some of them are still there, but the ones that were hired to come in and change all this are all gone. The management, the anchors, everybody else.
I don't want to boycott Channel 7, even though I hate Andy Shaw personally, but come on.
What in the
Should he have said, what the hell are we talking about? This has nothing to do with city government.
Right, you're arguing over millionaires, and these are millionaires that have nothing to do with the comings and goings of the average Chicagoan, other than, you know, who you turn on and watch on TV.
What is the problem? She couldn't come to terms with a contract that was north of $2 million a year.
Right.
So she'll probably get that at Channel 2. So what's the problem?
That was the Felicia Middlebrooks thing that was just hysterical. Was that Felicia Middlebrooks wanted to really cash in at this point on the rating success that her radio station has had. Well, that's all well and good if the words are coming out of your head into your mouth and out over the transmitter, you probably could garner a lot more money. But if somebody else is writing all the words for you and you're reading them, they could hire anybody to do that.
As you know, it doesn't have to be logical to be an issue in the city council.
That is unbelievable. When are the feds going to kick in the door at the city council and arrest them all?
Well, they have several times.
So if Bert Nateris brings up Mankow's contract, that's okay?
I'd report it.
I don't think he knows who he is, but if he brought it up.
Oh, Mankow!
I think the findings of these hearings, if they come across, is that the media treat minorities pretty darn well.
Yeah, I would say so. The media treats most of their employees pretty well. Hey, Mankow's getting, what is it, $3 million a year? I would like an investigation into Eddie and Jobo, if at all possible. Could I get Alderman Coleman to go into it? Let's take a look at that.
I don't think so.
Remember, there was a funny deal where there was a woman who sued WGCI years ago because she was working the overnight shift and she was only making one-tenth of what the morning guy was making?
Yeah, and that's the way it should be.
And she argued that it was because she was a woman. that she wasn't being paid that.
No, because they can't make much money on the overnight show as they can on a morning show. Listen, if you have to be taught the economics of broadcasting and you're in the third largest city, maybe you should be doing something else.
Oh, Lord, please let Channel 2 open their checkbook. Let's go north of $4 million now. Lord, if you're out there.
Well, let me just say this, that if in any way Channel 2 thought, and I'm not accusing them of this, but if anybody blew a call in to some alderman from Channel 2 last night and said, hey, Diane's going to be there, and wouldn't it be nice if somebody said something really nice about her and kind of stirred up the pot a little bit.
Keep her name alive for a few more months, because we can't really talk to her until June.
This is going to... I don't know, they can talk to her now.
I thought that they can't until her...
They're still paying her at Channel 7. Yeah, but they're paying her to keep her off the air. She can talk to anybody at that point. She's not working there.
Right, what's the worst that could happen? They fire her?
The worst that could happen is that they hire her and then they stop paying her.
Okay.
Wait, Gary's got another worst scenario.
No, I thought that she couldn't even talk to them until they're done paying her.
But that's the deal. So let her... So now Channel 2 is really up against it. Channel 2 has got to hire her. Otherwise, there will be an international investigation into Channel 2's behavior as it pertains to Diane Burns.
Here's Camille. Camille, you're on WLS. Hi.
Hey, guys, listen. I teach school in Englewood. I've met Dorothy Coleman. There are so many things...
No, it's Shirley Coleman, Dorothy Tillman.
Whatever. I met her. She's not friendly. I have so many things that we need to talk about in terms of Englewood and those kids and that neighborhood. This gets on my nerves. And I'm black. And listen, this is ridiculous. This is the kind of stuff that really ticks me off. I don't care. You guys can make fun of her if you want to. I've had it with this. The situation is dumb.
Yeah, it is stupid because...
Two millionaires fighting. Give me a break.
If this is all that she has to worry about in her district...
Call me. Tell her to call me. I'll tell her some more things that she
can be
talking
about. Yeah, Englewood. Isn't Englewood like one of the most depressed and crime-ridden areas in the city?
Allegedly. I don't know. I got my kids. I'm trying to get ready for these standardized tests that are coming up. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, we do.
We're busting our behind, and they're getting ready for these tests, and she's over here talking about Shapura and Diane Burns' $2.2 million a month.
Right.
Give me a break.
When we first heard that, we couldn't believe it either.
This is ridiculous. I'm going to go talk it up at school tomorrow, because I met her when she came to the school for a parent function, an evening function. She was the most unfriendly woman, and I don't care who wants to call in and refute me.
Who, the alderman?
She shook my hand with two fingers. You know, you hate people who do that.
The alderman did that?
Yes.
You know what's worse is when they shake your hand with just their fingers. I hate that.
The two fingers.
Oh, that's the worst.
You know.
All right. Well, for that, there should be a federal investigation into this.
Absolutely.
Thank you, Camille.
Bye.
Bye.
Yeah. Ms. Coleman shouldn't be charged, the city shouldn't be charged for her performance today, that's for sure.
Al?
Yeah, how's it going?
Good.
I look for you guys a lot lately.
Thank you.
I'm an African-American. I think Jesse Jackson and the rest of them people have lost their minds. They definitely don't speak to me.
Right, they're going for the high profile. They're just doing high profile stuff.
High profile, my. I'm like the lady just called. I mean, there's a heck of a lot of other stuff they can be talking about.
That's right.
Dealing with the city of Chicago. And this just shows you how blind they really are about not just African-Americans, but about the needs of the city of Chicago.
Yeah.
I mean, come on. I mean, all right. For instance, what do we talk about the park down there that's been overran? The mayor's been doing a fair job, but hell, cut some of that money and send it to the schools. What's happening with the lottery money that we were supposed to be getting for the schools? But every year, taxes need to go up to help bail out the schools.
Right.
Where's the lottery money going to?
Yeah, that whole thing, when you ask about the lottery money, they have a whole response that you can't even follow. Well, we take it in and then we put it somewhere, and then it comes back out, and then it goes to the school.
We only said it was going to be $600 million, because that's what the budget was before. Now it's coming directly out of lottery money, not out of the school fund, and we're helping out with this. And then I don't know what happened to it, but I'm going on vacation. See you. Goodbye.
I bet you what? I bet you it wound up being a boat in Chicago, and then they're going to say we need the boat to help pay for the schools, and so we don't have to raise taxes. And as soon as the boat is built, they're going to raise taxes again. They say they have to pay for the modification.
That's something to talk about. No. It's more important. Diane Burns has been brought forth to create the ratings, to bring forth the ratings.
Uh-huh.
I just even like to watch that lady doing the Boozing Day Parade, not alone watch a newscast. Come on.
Thank you, Al.
All right.
All right, thanks.
Dawn would like to explain the biblical reference to us. Hello, Dawn.
Hi, guys. How are you doing?
Good.
Good. I'm wondering why she's using, you know, like Hebrew references for Diane. Queen Esther and then Shiphrah and Puah were like midwives. Pharaoh told them to kill the male Hebrew babies, and they didn't do it. And that's how they, you know, saved the nation there. But Diane's not Jewish, is she?
She might be. I don't know. We haven't checked her card recently. Her driver's license, it says it right there.
You know, but Queen Esther and, you know, she saved her people, and Shiphrah and Puah kind of did the same thing with
all right,
the
we're just trying to figure out Shiphrah and Puah. That was something that went right over our... If it wasn't in a Cecil B. DeMille movie, I don't know about it.
Well, it was around the time of Moses, see? He was one of the babies that was saved.
So Shiphrah and Puah, oh, they are in that movie at the very beginning.
Yeah, when the midwives were supposed to be killing the male babies, these two ladies were, like, in charge of all the midwives.
Oh, all right. Shiphrah.
Now Ro can identify with it in the movie.
I got it. Yeah, as long as they're in the movie, I get it. Thank you, Don.
The thing, he reads Parade Magazine. If it's not in that...
Forget about it.
Forget about it. He loves those interviews. He calls me up Sundays.
Darren, you're on WLS.
Hey, guys.
Hi.
Actually, you are correct, Ro. I am a real estate appraiser, and I do a lot of work down in Englewood, and it is one of the most depressed areas of the city, at least as far as real estate goes.
Well, maybe Diane Burns will give some money to Englewood after her
contract.
Well, I
was thinking, as much work as I do down there, I'm kind of guessing that Diane's not one of her constituents.
Think so?
I'm just throwing it out. I haven't done the I haven't done the research, but
I can assure you that she is not. Oh. I can say without fear of contradiction that Diane Burns does not live in Englewood.
Okay, because I know about all those lawsuits, Ro. You got to watch yourself.
Yeah, you never know. But in this case, I have a darn good instinct on this.
Well, I want our contract up at the city council in a year. I want to hear something on the floor.
No, I really mean it. Ro and Gary are having a tough time over there signing the new deal. Now, let's take a vote.
What?
They'll be rushing to us immediately.
35 tomorrow, Christina.
Inbound Ian's at Dundee, a crash in the left lane. That's 25 Lake Cook to the Kennedy. Kennedy 30 either way. Eisenhower inbound 40 minutes. Dan Ryan 18 either direction. Everything else is good. This report brought to you by Orkin Pest Control. Did you know that the Orkin Man takes ongoing classes to keep up with the latest on pest control? Remember, if it bugs you, bug the Orkin Man at 1-800-ORKIN-MAN. I'm Christina Filiaggi with WLS Time Saver Traffic.
People ask us about our bright smile.